Okay, so we're gonna have a quick look at using KC, the equilibrium constant for AS chemistry. Okay, so this is slightly different from using the KC at A2 chemistry, where you would be carrying out calculations based on KC. So if we just very quickly, and I don't want to talk too much about the equilibrium because there's another video on that, but if we just look at a couple of reactions which sit at equilibrium. So we spoke about this already, and so if we have, let's say, two reactions at equilibrium. So the question is, if I said to you, well, both of those lie to the right-hand side, so hopefully you guys would be able to understand and explain that that means there's more product than there are reactants in each case. But then I might say to you, well, okay, well, which one lies further to the right-hand side? And obviously, that's impossible for you to say from the information that we've given you here. So this is where the equilibrium constant, or the KC, comes into play. KC is a numerical value which gives you an idea of the actual position of equilibrium, and it is very simply written. If I just write it for the above one, if I just put in number w the ones here, guys, which are the stoichiometric numbers, our stoichiometric coefficients. So it is written as, and I'll explain what these square brackets mean just in a little second. Okay, 1 to 1 to 1 to 1. So the square brackets in chemistry have the convention of concentration. So when I write C in square brackets, I'm referring to the concentration of C, likewise for A, B, and D. This 1 here is simply the stoichiometric coefficient that we have in all our equations, and that's where we get that from. Now, what does KC mean? Well, really, if we look at it, it's a ratio of the concentration at equilibrium risen to the power of their stoichiometric coefficients over the concentration of products. And obviously, the bigger the KC is, the further the equilibrium, therefore, lies to the right-hand side. And really, as far as we're concerned at AS level, that's just, we don't need to know a huge amount more than that. We have to be able to work out the units to be able to explain whether changing KC is telling me it's exo or endothermic. So if I very sort of crudely said I had a KC here of 10 and a KC here of 100, well, that would tell me that this equilibrium, the second one, EFGH, lies considerably further, or 10 times, if you like, further to the right-hand side than the top KC. It's a bit of a crude way to look at it, but it gets the point across for AS chemistry. So the next thing that we got to be able to do then is to work out the, to of course write the KC, and then we've also got to be able to work out the units for KC. They're pretty easy to do. A bit of basic math, well, maybe not basic maths, but certainly some maths that should be well within any AS chemistry student. Right, so if I just look at the one that I have on the board, which I suppose is the simplest of the lot, our units of concentration, or the standard unit of concentration, which are moles to the 1 dm to the minus 3. So the top line there would read as so. Likewise, of course, the bottom line would read exactly the same in terms of units. So they just all cancel each out. And in this instance, our KC, whatever the numerical value would be, and again, at the AS level, you don't have to calculate it, would actually have no units. And that's perfect, and that's what you would write. Don't leave, or say it's blank, or leave it, leave the answer blank if they ask for the units of KC in this particular instance. It's not blank, okay? It's no units is what you write. All right, so let's have a look at, I'll change this one a little bit, okay, just to give us a different KC expression, and then to work out the units. Now, if you want to pause this video and work out the units yourself for these ones, it's probably a good idea, and then come back and check the answers. Okay, so if we look at the bottom, the KC expression first of all of the game. Probably just again pause this and write the KC expression and come back and check that that's all right as well. So that's C upon D. I'm not going to write the ones in this time because it's not good practice to do so. Okay, and B to the 2 this time because of obviously that 2 that we've got up there. Right, so the units then, well, the top line will be moles dm to the minus 3 multiplied by moles dm to the minus 3. They're both to the 1, so bottom line moles dm to the minus 3. Now multiplied by moles dm to the minus 3, if you like. This is a bit of a long-winded way to do it, but I want to sort of lay it out in as simple a way as I can for some people who might not be so naturally gifted at it. So get rid of that 1 1, okay, and then I can get rid of one more here because I've got that on that, yeah. So one, if you like. Okay, so I now have 1 over moles dm to the minus 3, which then my final units will of course be moles to the minus 1 dm to the 3. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. Alright, I'll change this, I'll probably just do one more here, I'll change this up a little bit again. Okay, so put the 2 there, okay. So this time RKC very simply becomes, again you can stop the video and practice this yourself, okay, over D, A, times B. So that would be your KC expression that you'd write. And then top line we have moles dm to the minus 3 multiplied by moles dm to the minus 3 multiplied by moles dm to the minus 3. Hopefully by the time you do the exam you'll have to write all this out, you'll start to kind of pick up the shortcuts. Okay, and the bottom line is simply that. So cancel, 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 cancel. Okay, so we have top line now, we have moles dm, just write it down, moles dm to the minus 3 divided by 1, anything divided by 1. It's of course itself, so the units in that instance are simply moles dm to the minus 3. Okay, so that's how you use those to work out write the KC expression and then to work out the units. Okay, there's a few of those that you can practice in your notes. I suppose I should have added earlier that we're doing, we only do homogeneous equilibria at AS level, and homogeneous means where all things are in the same physical state. In KC expressions, if you get a solid, okay, that does not appear in the KC expression. KC expression is a concentration equilibrium expression, and solids don't have a change in concentration from that perspective, so don't put solids in place. Okay, right. I suspect at ASW you'll only get aqueous solutions. Right, so going on from there then, they may say, okay, well this substance here, this reaction here, sorry, has a KC of 10 at maybe 278 kelvins. Okay, and then if we did the same reaction and measured the KC, this time equals 100 at 298 kelvins. So what does that tell us? Well, the KC is essentially a measure of how much product we have compared to reactant. So therefore at the higher temperature the KC is larger, so we have more product at the higher temperature. Okay, so what does that tell me? Well, that tells me at a higher temperature the equilibrium moves to the forward reaction. If you think back to the last video or the class that we did on this, at higher temperatures it is an endothermic reaction which moves forward. Ok Okay, with addition of heat. So in other words, I've added heat, there's more product. So in other words, the equilibrium is moved to the right hand side. So the four direction must be endothermic in this case. And again, you might have to ask that, or you may well be asked that. Conversely, if we sort of looked at this one here, we might go, okay, well, as the temperature is lowered, the Kc goes down, and that tells me therefore that there are more reactants in here than there are products now. Okay, sorry, up here compared to down here, there are more reactants. So that's at a lower temperature, and we should know that lowering the temperature favors the exothermic reaction. Okay, and so that tells me that this reaction is the forward reaction is endothermic because at lower temperatures the Kc is lower, so therefore the reverse reaction must be exothermic. Okay, so you may well be asked to use it from that perspective as well and work out whether reactions are exothermic or endothermic based on Kc values. Remember, it's only temperature that changes the Kc value for a particular reaction, changing concentrations, pressures, and certainly not catalyst. Do not have the ability to change Kc expressions, Kc number values. Okay, hopefully that is of some use to you guys, and you can ask me any questions if you're struggling. There's a few questions in your notes, okay, that you can find and to test yourselves.